Welcome to the channel. I recently completed a video on the Backfire G3, and a lot of people responded and said, hey, how would you compare the X-Way X1 Pro Riot to the Backfire G3? And they wanted it from the perspective of a 225-pound rider, so that's what we're going to be discussing today. Which board should you get? We're going to start the conversation with probably one of the things that really separates these two boards, which is the deck. With the Backfire G3, you have a flexible deck system. And with that flexible deck system, you're allowed to have the dual enclosure system. And what you'll see under there is the battery and the ESC. And the flexible decks allow a couple of different things. One of which, it kind of improves the rider comfort because the flex of the deck kind of acts as shocks in the vehicle. So when you're riding with the board, as you're hitting bumps and different things like that, the board is actually swaying and kind of to eat up some of those bumps and those vibrations. So it kind of makes the ride a little bit more comfortable. And when you look at the X-Way, what you'll notice is you don't see any enclosures on the bottom of the board. And that is because everything is actually encased within the deck of the board, the ESC and the batteries. And as a result, X-Way had to make the deck hard to protect the internal components so that when you step on a board, it's not flexing and bending and you break anything with the board. So both of these boards here, people say, what's better? And to be honest about it, I was a person that leaned on the side of stiffer decks. I purchased the Backfire G2T because I liked that it had a stiffer deck. I purchased the X-Way because I liked that it had a stiffer deck as well. And that was because with my weight, I was so concerned about when I was riding, would the bottom of the board be scraping against the ground or hitting things as I was riding. So that's why I went ahead with the stiffer deck systems. However, when I got the Backfire G3, what I realized is that it's not necessarily the flexible deck itself that could be problematic. It is the amount of flex that the deck actually has itself. And there's going to be boards out there, some that have really flexy decks, and then there's going to be some that almost have like that perfect flex thing going on there where it's flexible but also rigid enough to hold somebody who is my weight. And the Backfire G3 is one of those boards. Really, this board has changed my mind dramatically about flexible decks on boards. And really, I almost kind of prefer flexible decks over stiffer deck systems now because I like the fact that when I'm riding with flexible decks, it's eating up the vibration, it's eating up the cracks. It also kind of helps with carving and pumping. You're almost able to kind of rebound off of the board when you're carving and you're pumping. So I really enjoy the flexible deck systems right now. Now, is one better than the other? Not necessarily, because the stiffer deck also has its place. Not only is it good for heavier riders, it also comes in play when you're talking about high speed riding. Generally speaking, when you're riding incredibly hard and incredibly aggressive, stiffer decks are a little bit better, generally considered to be better because they're not swaying and flopping if you're going 28, 27, 30 miles an hour on a skateboard. So really when you talk about flexible decks, like I said, it boils down to personal preference, but I wanted to give you guys something to think about when you talk about the flex of these decks and the flex of these boards here. The ESCs. Both of these boards utilize the Hobbywing ESC, which is a very respected ESC. However, what I can tell you is that the X-Way uses a very beefed up Hobbywing ESC, and it allows you to do some ridiculous customizations. Adjust the braking curve, acceleration curve. You can adjust whether or not you want to turn on standby mode, which allows you to turn the board on and off by just using the remote. You don't have to bend over and touch a button, which is pretty cool. It allows you to turn on something called free mode. And free mode on the board allows you to, when you pull back on the throttle, instead of just braking, the board actually goes in reverse. It's very similar to what Boosted Board does and how their boards brake. They don't brake, the board actually goes in reverse. So when you talk about the customization that you're able to do with the X-Way and this app, it's pretty amazing. Really, you're getting a lot of features that you will see in some very high-end boards at a very reasonable price with the X-Way board. Now, the Hobbywing ESC on the Backfire G3 is very good as well. Very responsive. The braking is good. The acceleration is good. It's intuitive. I've never had issue with it disconnecting from the board. It just doesn't have all those crazy bells and whistles that allow you to come in and customize stuff. What you get with the board is what you get. And it's a pretty good system. It's a pretty good board. But don't expect to be able to go in an app and change anything, change a braking curve, change the acceleration curve, or anything like that. However the board is set up from Backfire, that's what you're going to get. Nevertheless, they both have really good ESCs. You just get a chance to really customize the ride experience on the X-Way board. So once again, it boils down to rider preference. Are you somebody that really wants to customize everything? Are you somebody that just, you know, as long as the factory sets it up well, you're good with that? So it's personal preference when you talk about the ESCs. Drivetrain system and wheels. The X-Way comes in two flavors. When you purchase the X-Way, you get to decide, do you want the hub motor system or do you want the belt driven system? When you buy the Backfire G3, the only option that you have is the hub motor system. Now, how the hub motor systems work is you have a motor in the back of the board, and that's on the back of the board, and it's encased in polyurethane, and that polyurethane serves as like the rubber or the wheel for the actual rear tires of the board. Now, there's a lot of people out there that prefer the belt driven systems over the hub systems, because when you're utilizing a belt driven system, you're able to utilize four real wheels. And some will say, well, why is that so significant? What does that mean? What happens is when you're using four real wheels, once again, it allows you to customize the rider experience. You get to select the type of wheels that you want, color, durometer, size, if you want to put all terrain wheels on there. So you have a lot of different options. And then also, when you talk about four real wheels, generally speaking, it's a little bit more comfortable because you're dealing with a real wheel, you're dealing with the thickness of the wheel, and then also the grippiness of the wheel could be a little bit better. However, when you talk about the Backfire G3, even though it is a hub-driven system, it rides very similarly to a belt-driven system. And the reason why is because Backfire, the G3 ships with 96 millimeter wheels, which are very, very big. And when you look at that back wheel, the polyurethane wrapped around the hub motor is incredibly thick. So you get a lot of the benefits of a real wheel with the Backfire hub motor wheel because of the thickness of the polyurethane. You're gonna get grip. It doesn't vibrate a whole lot. The size of the wheel itself allows it to eat up bumps and cracks in the road and roll over things smoothly without making a very uncomfortable ride. So even though you're talking with the Backfire G3, it's a hub motor system, it's very comparable to the ride of a belt driven system. So for example, let me just give you a quick example. My very first board that I bought was a Wago 2S, and the polyurethane on that back wheel is so thin. You literally feel every bump, every crack, you just feel it because the polyurethane is so thin, it just makes the ride not as comfortable. And that's a completely different story with the Backfire G3. And it's a very comfortable ride. And like I said, it rivals the ride of many other belt-driven systems. Another component when you talk about hub versus belt systems is that hub motors are generally considered to be a little bit less maintenance. And that's because when you have a belt-driven system, there's a little bit more work that goes there. The belts get worn out. They might snap. They might break. You need to replace them. Sometimes when you're riding with the boards, the belts stretch over time. You may have to adjust the belt tension. Sometimes if you're riding in places where it's a lot of dirt and gravel and things like that, when you're riding over it, the likelihood of those things getting in the belts or getting in the pulleys and things like that, it can cause a problem. So you have to do a little bit more maintenance in those type of situations. Whereas with the hub motors, it's a little bit more of an enclosed system. So you're not going around changing belts. You don't have to necessarily worry about it getting as dirty and you needing to go in and clean things. It's just a little less maintenance. So there are some people, all they want to do is get on the board on Sunday afternoons and ride. They don't want to think about, hey, do I need to tighten belt tension? Hey, are my belts wearing thin? You know, do I got to carry extra belts in my bag when I'm riding because it might snap while I'm riding? Those kind of people, they may want to go toward a hub motor system. But there's some people out there that saying, look, I want the customized experience. I want four real wheels. I want to put all-terrain wheels on. I want to be able to change the durometer on the wheels of my board. Well, a belt-driven system would probably be for you. A final component when you talk about belts versus hubs, and we talked about like the maintenance and things getting inside of them, you know, hubs do a little bit better if you're in situations where your board might get wet, might get dirty. It performs a little bit better in those type of scenarios. Now, with the belt-driven systems, the X-Ray, this is my first belt-driven board. And I'll be 100% transparent. I was concerned about the maintenance. I was like, oh my God. I was excited to get a belt drive board. But then in the back of my mind, I was also thinking about, okay, the maintenance that I may have to do, the things that I may have to do to keep the board looking well. I'm here to tell you that it hasn't been that big of an issue. And what's interesting is that when you get a board, what you're going to find is that you're actually going to like tinkering with the board. You're going to like changing the belts. You're going to like cleaning the bearings because it just makes it for an intimate experience with the board. So when you talk about drivetrain system, once again, it's personal preference. It's what you want. Like I said, the Backfire G3 rides like a belt-driven system. When you talk about the torque and acceleration and things like that, which we'll talk a little bit about more, but the ride comfort, when you talk about the vibration, when you talk about having grip, all of those things, both of these boards do very well. It's really rider preference. Torque, power, and acceleration. One of the biggest misconceptions out there about belt drive boards versus hub motor boards is that all belt drive boards have more acceleration and more torque than hub motor boards. And that may have been the case a couple of years ago, but technology has changed and hub motors have really increased in that area. And I'm here to tell you that the Backfire G3 has a lot of power, a lot of torque, a lot of acceleration, just like the X-Way. They both are very high performing boards. And really, it's really kind of amazing. In my review of the G3, I showed some video of me riding up hills and different things like that. And I was just shocked at the amount of power that the board had and the amount of torque and acceleration that the board had. It really is really a step up from the Backfire G2T. Now, both of these boards, you can enable torque on these boards. I'm sorry, turbo on these boards. And the turbo or actually on the X-Way is enabled inside of the app. So when you go inside the app and you switch on turbo, anytime you're in the four speed mode, it allows you to exceed the top speed on the board. There's actually no top speed limit, but most people on the X-Way get 28, 29 miles an hour when you're full throttle in the board. And of course, that's incredibly fast. The X-Ways are known for just having great torque, great power and acceleration, and it does that very well. The turbo on the Backfire is a little bit different. The turbo is actually activated by pressing a button on the remote. And interestingly, the turbo on the Backfire G3 is different from the turbo that we saw on the Backfire G2T. And the turbo on the previous generation of Backfire boards, when you activated it, it only lasted for 30 seconds. And after that 30 seconds, there was a 30 second cooldown where you couldn't use it. And a lot of people did not like the way that turbo was set up on those boards. But with the new Backfire, that turbo is unlimited and it is very fun. So when you turn on that turbo button, it allows you to get some increased top speed. And I think it goes upwards of 28 miles an hour. And then when you turn on the turbo, the lights on the bottom of the board also flash very quickly. So both of these boards have a lot of acceleration. They have a lot of torque. And if you were to say, hey, Phillips, which board is faster? Which board has more torque? I'm gonna say both of these boards is very close. The X-Way might have a tiny bit more, but I mean, it's so close and it's so hard to tell that literally probably the only way you would be able to do this is to go somewhere and sit down and have scientific tests and test each board back to back under different scenarios to really find out what is what. But just jumping on a board and riding, I mean, it's really close. I couldn't say one was necessarily faster than the other one. It's really close. So both of these boards have great power, torque, and acceleration. Very good job on both of these boards. Range and battery. This is one of the areas where there is a difference. Just like with the X-Way, I said that the ESC was really beefed up, and that's an area that the X-Way has an advantage. The Backfire G3 actually has an advantage in the battery and the range that the board gets. The Backfire G3 has a 260 watt hour battery, whereas the X-Way I think only has about 190. And in addition to that, the Backfire, because it has a dual enclosure system and the batteries are under the board, they're able to use more cells, larger battery cells. So you're going to get more range on the Backfire G3 than what you get on the X-Way. As I mentioned in my previous video, the Backfire G3, I was shocked at the range that I got. I think I got about 12 to 13 miles on the board riding aggressively during a group ride. Up hills, riding quick, accelerating hard, braking hard, going up hills. And I got 13 miles on the board. And that was also with me turning turbo on throughout the ride as well, turning it off and riding in sport mode. So the battery and the range on the Backfire is very impressive. But in addition to the range being impressive, one of the other things that was really, you know, eye-opening as well was the lack of battery sag. And what battery sag is that when you go through the battery on electric devices, as you, especially on electric skateboards, as you get through that battery, as you go from 100% to 90 to 80 to 40 to, you know, 30% of the battery, the board loses a little bit of performance. It may not be able to hit the top speed like it did at 100%, at 30%, and so on and so forth. But what I'm here to tell you is that this Backfire G3, the battery sag is very minimal. I think I was at like 20% battery and I was still able to hit over 20 miles per hour, which is incredibly impressive for a board. And even I think I got down to like 10% and a board was still very quick. And I can accelerate hard. So that's definitely one of the things that the Backfire G3 is doing very well as far as like the range and the battery and the voltage sag. All of those things make for a great riding experience. Now, the X-Way is incredibly fast, as I mentioned before. However, you do see a performance difference in the board as you get through the battery. And that performance difference increases as you get through the battery. So the X-Way at 100%, from 90 to 100%, is one of the fastest production boards that you can get out there for a reasonable price. Yeah, there's $4,000 boards out there that are faster. But from a perspective of the price of this board, when the battery's at 90 to 100%, this thing is quick. But as you go through the battery, you lose a little performance. And you're not able to hit that top speed like you did when you were at 90 or 100% of the board. And that it becomes even more pronounced as you get even further through the battery. So when you get down to 20 and 30 and 40%, you don't have the same performance in the board as you did when the board was at 90 or 100%. Now, a lot of people make up for that with the X-Way by purchasing the fast charger, which allows you to charge the board up to full in anywhere from 30 to 40 minutes. So some people ride the board real hard, you know, for 3, 4, 5 miles, stop, charger back up and are back full in 30 minutes and ride hard some more. So that's how some people kind of circumvent that. But really, the X-Way is kind of at a disadvantage when you talk about battery and range and stuff like that, because they're squeezing everything into the deck. They can't use as big a cells. They can't use as many cells because everything is going inside of the deck on the board compared to a board like the Backfire G3 where the battery and everything is up under the board. So if you're somebody who's looking for range and you want to be able to push the board hard and not have to worry about battery sag and don't have to worry about, okay, can I do more than 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 miles, then the Backfire G3 might be something that you're looking for. Now, if you're somebody that you're like, look, my X-Way is going to be used as a last means of transportation, I get off of the bus, I got 3 miles to ride, then the X-Way is something that you probably really, really want to look into. But these boards are just a little bit different in that the Backfire just has a bigger battery on it. And the cells that they're using, it just has less battery sag. So you're going to get a little bit more, you're going to get more range out of the board, and you're going to be able to get higher performance out of the board, even though the battery is starting to get lower than what you would see on the X-Way. But like I said, a lot of people circumvent that by utilizing the fast charger. So it's really about rider preference and what you want from the board, how fast you want to go on the board, and things like that. But nevertheless, you know, both of these boards are solid in that area. Brakes. One thing that people don't consider when they look at electric skateboards, a lot of people look at the top speed. Oh, 30 miles an hour, 28 miles an hour, whatever the top speed is. But they don't think about, okay, I should also be concerned about braking. Because if I'm going 25, 26, 30 miles an hour, I also need to be able to stop consistently and safely. And both of these boards do a great job with braking. However, the X-Way has very good brakes. And really, the brakes are so good that almost any board that you would compare the brakes to on the X-Way, I don't say any, but a lot of boards that you would compare the braking to on the X-Way would exceed them with the braking. And X-Way just does an amazing job with the brakes. And if I was to give it a score, I would say out of a 10, the X-Way brakes are probably like a 9.5. Whereas with the Backfire G3, I would give the brakes about an 8.5. maybe an 8.8. And you know, with the X-Way, you're able to like brake aggressively if you want to. You don't have to, but it allows you, it's so confidence inspiring that you don't mind going real fast because you know you can stop real good too. The Backfire's brakes are excellent as well, good as well, but at the end when you're stopping, you just wish they had a little bit more bite. As I mentioned in my previous video about the Backfire G3, I said that if Backfire was able to increase those brakes maybe about 10%, then they would just have it going on. So, you know, both of these boards have good brakes, but the X-Way has a little bit better brakes. And then on top of that, as I mentioned before, you get to customize your brake experience within the X-Way app as well. So if you want them even more aggressive, you can make them more aggressive. Or if you don't want them as aggressive, you can turn it down as well in that component. So when you talk about brakes, both of these boards have good brakes, but the X-Way probably has a little bit better brakes. But nevertheless, good brakes on both of these boards here. Aesthetics and look. Both of these boards, to me, look very good. But of course, they have different looks to them. The X-Way went for that real sleek look. It looks so aerodynamic because it doesn't have enclosures on the bottom of it. So it just looks so good. The coating that they put on the bottom of the board, it doesn't get dirty. It always looks brand new. I've had this board for months, and it's like if anything gets on it, just wipe it, it comes right off. I mean, it just looks very good. There's nothing to complain about. The Backfire looks good as well. You know, even though it's using the dual enclosure systems, the styling and the curvature of them, I like the way it looks. And then also, Backfire put the lights on there. So you can turn on the lights when you're riding or when you're using turbo, it flashes hard. So when you talk about aesthetics of these boards, both of these boards look good, and I don't think that anybody looking at them would say, "Ooh, that's an ugly board." They just are styled differently, and I think people are going to just have different styles. You know, it's just like people that choose the type of shoe that they want to wear. You know, that shoe may not be ugly, it's just not your style. And I think with both of these boards, they both look good. When you talk about style, it really would be about rider preference. Portability. When you talk about portability in these boards here and which one's easier to carry around, once again, it's going to be that rider preference. One of the things that the X-Way has going for it is that standby mode, which is amazing, which allows you to turn that board on without bending over and turning the board on. And some people say, dude, is it really that big of a deal? Yeah, it makes a world of difference. This was my first board with that feature. And there will be many a times when you're out where you may have been riding public transportation, or you just want to turn it on real quick and ride out. You know, that one less step that you have to do of turn on the remote, bend over, turn the board on, you know, sit the board back down, get on the board, ride out. That's one less step that you have to do because you just turn the board on with the remote and you just can ride out. So it makes it pretty portable. Like if you're trying to use public transportation, you have to turn the board on and off because you jumped on the bus or the train, jumped off the train, got to turn the board back on to ride out. But one of the things I will say from a portability standpoint, the X-Way is a little bit shorter than the Backfire G3. And because of that, I cannot pull the X-Way. So a lot of times if I'm having to walk a distance or I'm in an area where I can't ride my board and I have to like carry it, sometimes I'll just pull the board with the front wheels. But I can't do that with the X-Way because of the length of it. When I stand up and I pull it, the bottom of the board actually scrapes the ground. So I cannot pull it. Whereas with the Backfire G3, because of the length of the deck, I can actually walk and pull the board. And I like that a lot because that means I don't have to carry the board around. So that's one of the elements I really like about the Backfire G3. And for me, with my height, I like being able to pull the board. Like it makes a world of difference. But somebody that's shorter than me, that may not be a problem, pulling the X-Way. So once again, pros and cons there. You have to decide what works best for you. But from a portability standpoint, I guess you got to say the X-Way is a tad bit more portable because of that standby mode feature and not having to bend over and turn the board on and off. Remote. Both of these boards utilize a very good remote. They both have LED screens on them, which gives you basic information. The battery life of the remote, the battery life of the board, how many miles per hour, kilometers you're riding, how many miles you've ridden during this current ride. Where they do differ is that with the Backfire remote, it also has an odometer on there. So it tells you how far you've ridden in a total life of this board, in addition to just like how many miles or kilometers you've ridden at this particular moment. With the X-Way remote, you don't see that displayed on the remote. You just see how many miles you've traveled at this particular ride. However, that odometer is actually inside of the app for X-Way. Once again, that'll be personal preference. I do like having the odometer on the remote and being able to just see it quickly to see like how many miles I've done or something like that. So that comes in handy. One of the things that I do like about the Backfire remote is this, the little hole that they have on the actual remote where you can put your finger in there. That's pretty cool because then you don't always have to use the lanyard that comes with the remote, because with your finger near the remote, it's not going to go anywhere and it just feels good. The Backfire remote is actually a little bit larger, so my hands are larger, so it feels really good in my hand. But nevertheless, the X-Way remote feels good as well. No complaints there. Really, when you talk about remotes, they're like a wash. They're almost even. They're both good remotes. The scroll wheels both feel good and they're very responsive for braking and acceleration. So really, they're even. There's nothing like really to like, oh, this remote is better than the other one. They're pretty even. I do like the Backfire remote maybe a tiny bit more, but once again, that's gonna be rider preference. Trucks. The X-Way, both of these boards utilize reputable trucks. The X-Way utilizes Seismic trucks and the Backfire board utilizes Caliber trucks. Both of these trucks are reputable name brand companies and people respect them. However, there are some differences in these trucks. With the Seismic trucks, they use a proprietary bushing, and the way the bushing is shaped is not a traditional bushing shape. And as a result, if you want to adjust the bushings on your board, you have to purchase them from Seismic. This is different from the Caliber trucks, which are a little bit more open source, which means that you can buy bushings from dozens of other companies to personalize the rider experience. Now, some will say, well, why would I even want to change my bushings if these are good trucks? You may want to change the bushings to meet your needs as a rider. For example, with the X-Way, I actually changed the bushings because I wanted bushings with a higher durometer so that when I'm riding, they're stiffer. They were balanced better for me and my weight. And people often do that. Lighter riders like to put bushings with a lower durometer. They like to use bushings that are softer so they can maneuver the board better, whereas a lot of times heavier riders, they like to put stiffer bushings in there to compensate for us being heavier. That's different from the Caliber trucks, where like I said, you can purchase them from dozens of other places, so you have way more options when you talk about purchasing bushings and things like that for the trucks that you may want to use. Nevertheless, I would say both of these are really solid. I think that being able to customize the bushings and have dozens of providers that will fit might give the Backfire a little bit of an edge if you're into like really being able to customize things. But I would say that both of these trucks are very good. I mean, you really can't go wrong with either one of these trucks here. Final thoughts. A lot of people are going to say, okay, you've given me all the information. Which board would you buy? And that's a hard question to answer because everybody's looking for something different. Both of these boards have their strong suits. You know, the Backfire, the range, the battery, the torque, the acceleration, the lights that you get on the board. All of those things are really cool. The X-Way, the torque, the acceleration, the app. You can customize things. Four rear wheels, the ride system, the belt system, the option of having a belt or hub system. It has a lot going for it. Both of these boards have their pros. Both of them have their cons. But to be honest about it, if you're saying, look, should I get the X-Way Pro or the Backfire G3? I'm going to say you might be asking the wrong question. I think the correct question is, should I buy the X-Way Flex or the Backfire G3? And I think that that's a little bit more of a comparable comparison. However, I wanted to do this one because there are some people that are still looking at the X1 X1 Pro Ride because it still is a solid board and it offers a lot. Nevertheless, hopefully I said some things that help you make an educated decision about your purchase. That's always my goal when I do these videos. I want you to make sure you look into the description because I have some methods and ways for you to get some of these giveaways, guys. Man, Romp came through for us, guys. Romp, and these giveaways are a gift from Romp and then also the Atlanta Eastgate community, y'all. So check out the description. As always, I'll see you at the top. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Holla.